Hello Internet, welcome to another Waveguides tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to discuss the most important parameter in rectangular waveguides, propagation, that is cutoff wavelength and cutoff frequency. Now when we talk about cutoff wavelength, it is the maximum wavelength that is supported by a waveguide of certain dimension while propagating a certain mode. Now there are two things that we need to remember while understanding the definition of cutoff wavelength, apart from the formula of course. The first thing is, it is the maximum wavelength supported by a waveguide of certain dimension. Now please understand, maximum wavelength of the waveguide, the dimensions are A and B, they are not going to change. So, but that does not mean that the cutoff wavelength is also fixed, because it is dependent on the second other parameter, which is the modes. For example, we discussed various TE and TM modes. The subscript M and N, they also determine the cutoff wavelength. Now, I would not go into the details of M and N. M are the number of half cycles along the broader direction A. For example, just by looking at this diagram, we could infer that two signals or two kinds of modes are being made to propagate along the broader direction A. So M is the number of half cycles or the signals which are sent along A, and N is the number of half cycles which are sent along B. So the number of half cycles which are sent along B in this case is just one. So and we could have M and N as 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, up to any number. Of course, one of them is permitted to be 0 in the case of TE, as discussed in the previous tutorial, and some of the possible modes for TM are, they start from 1, 1, because none of them can be 0. They go to 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, and so on. So the maximum wavelength for a particular length of a waveguide for a particular mode will give you the cutoff wavelength. So the formula also depends upon the dimensions A and B, which are typically in the range of few centimeters. And M and N could be practically, you know, anything less than 9, or some practical values of M and N I've seen are 5, 7, etc. So again, maximum wavelength supported by a waveguide. And if we look into the definition of frequency, cutoff frequency, which is denoted by FC. By the way, cutoff wavelength is denoted by lambda C. Now FC would be the minimum frequency which can be made to propagate in a waveguide for, of course, certain dimension and certain mode. Now the definition of cutoff wavelength and cutoff frequency are not, they do not actually specify the maximum capability of a waveguide of certain dimension. So a more appropriate and more definitive definition, I would say, is the cutoff wavelength, which is denoted by lambda c, and cutoff frequency in dominant mode. Now, it is supremely important to understand the cutoff wavelength and cutoff frequency in dominant mode. Now, out of all the possible modes of TE and TM, we are going to determine that mode which will give us the maximum wavelength that can be made to propagate in a waveguide. And similarly, out of all the possible modes in transverse magnetic propagation, we are going to determine that particular mode which will allow us to send the maximum wavelength. And that is more definitive. For example, if we start to monitor for TE mode, we'll start with M is equal to 0 and N is equal to 1. That will give me a cutoff wavelength of 2B. If you put the formula, if you put the formula of values of M and N in this formula, we'll get lambda C to be equivalent to twice of B. This goes away, N is 1 and B comes out of the under root and we get 2B. And similarly, for M is equal to 1 and N is equal to 0, we get a cutoff wavelength of twice of A. And for M is equal to 1 and N is equal to 1, we get lambda C to be equivalent to twice of AB upon M squared plus N squared. Now we know that A is going to be greater than B in all the cases, because A is the broader dimension, B is the shorter dimension. So if we go any further, if we take, let us say, M is equal to 0 and N is equal to 2, that will in any case give me a cutoff wavelength which will be smaller than twice of B or smaller than twice of A. So we can say that for a particular waveguide of dimension A and B, if we use TE 1 0, that will allow me to propagate a wavelength of twice of A, which is the maximum wavelength that we can propagate in a waveguide, in this particular waveguide of dimension A and B. All the other modes will allow a wavelength which will be smaller in size. If you use 0 1, it will be twice of B, which will be smaller than twice of A. So it's important to understand that the maximum wavelength for a particular waveguide is supported by the dominant mode and the dominant mode in TE is 1-0, and the wavelength is twice of A. Now if you get a quick brainer question, like for a waveguide of 3 cm by 1.5 cm, what is the cutoff wavelength in TE 0-1 mode? So you could readily use this formula for 0-1, and you could say the cutoff wavelength lambda c for 0-1 mode is twice of B, which is 3 cm, and the cutoff wavelength in dominant mode is automatically understood that TE10 is dominant. So lambda C for dominant mode becomes twice of A, 6 cm. Now, on the similar lines, we can calculate dominant mode for TM. So we'll start from M is equal to 1, N is equal to 1, and lambda C turns out to be twice of AB upon M squared plus N squared. And as we go ahead, this could be our next lambda C will decrease. So the denominator is going to increase. That will result in the decreasing of cutoff wavelength. So we'd say the dominant mode for TM is twice of AB upon M squared plus N squared. And now we go to the discussion for cutoff frequency, denoted by FC. If the waveguide my waveguide of dimension A and B is air filled, that is, we have air inside the waveguide as the dielectric medium, then we could simply use the formula C by lambda. However, if the waveguide is not filled with air, we'll be given with the values of epsilon r and mu r, the relative permittivity and relative permeability of the dielectric medium. Now this C will be replaced with V, the velocity of the wave inside that particular dielectric, and that can be calculated by modifying C, because C is 1 upon under root mu naught epsilon naught, and our new velocity will be 1 upon mu naught mu r epsilon naught epsilon r. And this simple formula for cutoff frequency, if we know the cutoff wavelength, is C by lambda. But if lambda C is not calculated and you straight away want to calculate the cutoff frequency, then the formula is C by 2 and the whole thing in the numerator. Of course, this is derived from lambda C but represented like this. Now, once we understand that a waveguide's dimensions cannot be changed, so it's only the modes with which we can play around to sort of increase or decrease the operating frequency. We can, with this amount of understanding, we shall be able to solve numericals based upon cutoff wavelengths and cutoff frequency. And I shall continue this tutorial by taking up an example of a numerical in the next part. And thank you so much for watching this video. And if you found this video of any help, then please consider subscribing this channel. That is a great help to me, and it motivates me to make new videos. Thanks again for watching this. You have a good day and a good life. Bye.